But standing by right now, Cowboy Bill Watts, Executive Vice President, Wrestling Operations, World Championship Wrestling. He has some information on the light heavyweight tournament and the top rope rule.
We have two very important announcements tonight. Last week we had talked about the world's light heavyweight title because we had to strip Brad Armstrong since he was injured and unable to defend it for over 30 days. We talked about a tournament. Because of the contractual commitments, the logistics of contacting the top light heavyweight athletes all over the world, we're going to have that sometime after the first of the year. However, the fans made such a strong statement about my top rope rule that we're still going to address that because I believe that when the fans make a statement, we got to look at it seriously. The top rope rule, as of today, is rescinded completely in World Championship Wrestling. There is one situation where you can have a flagrant violation which will call for an automatic disqualification. And that's when, if you come off the top rope and your man is laying prone on the mat and you drive your knee into his head or his throat, it's a flagrant violation. We got six or eight examples that we'll show you, so you'll see what we mean right now. In this first example, there you see Rick Steiner climbing to the top, bulldogging Dallas Page off the top rope. That is now legal. In this example, in just a moment, you're going to see Ricky Steamboat, the Dragon, fly off the top rope in one of his high-risk spectacular moves with a cross-body block on the masked man. That is legal from now on. This is a more controversial example. Jushin Liger, one of the most exciting light heavyweights in the world. He comes off the top onto a man outside the ring. Again, that's legal as long as he beats the count back into the ring. Another very controversial situation with Ricky Morton, because it involves the knee and the man ends up prone on the mat. However, since Ricky Morton starts the maneuver here on the top, even though it's with the knee, the man wasn't lying prone on the mat when he came off on him. That is legal. In this example, Bobby Eaton, this will be a flagrant violation because he drives the knee into the throat and head area of Rick Steiner. That's a flagrant violation and he would be disqualified. In this example with the U.S. champion Rick Rude against the dynamite young Japanese superstar Sasaki, this would be illegal. This will be a flagrant violation under WCW rules because Rick comes off the top rope and drives the knee into the head and throat area. In this example again, Jushin Liger, his exciting high-risk maneuver. This is legal because even though the man's laying prone, he doesn't drive the knee into him. It's a crossbody block for the pin. Here's an example that the intent of the rule was designed for, to stop potential injury. Because when you got a guy the size of Big Van Vader, over 428 pounds coming off the top rope on people, somebody could actually be fatally injured. This is no longer illegal. This is a splash. He doesn't hit him with a knee. He drops that massive weight on their heads, but it's a splash. That's not a flagrant violation. It's not illegal from this point on.
So there you have it from Cowboy Bill Watts. What about that, Jeff?
I'll tell you, I love it. World Championship Wrestling, listening to its fans.
No question about that. And fans, we have an exciting hour of World Championship Wrestling. We kick it off with Heavy Metal Van Hammer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from New York City, weighing 291 pounds, Heavy Metal Van Hammer.
Heavy Metal Van Hammer making his way to the ring in our first matchup this week on Worldwide as we go back to Gary Capetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Los Angeles, California, 248 pounds, Kenny Kendall.
All right, and before the match gets underway this week on Worldwide, we have some pre-recorded comments from Heavy Metal Van Hammer. Let's listen in.
That's right, Van Hammer is back, and I'm rocking wrestling rings from coast to coast, border to border. Don't miss it when it comes to your town, because it's going to be fantastic. Woo!
Hip toss. As you hear the comments from Van Hammer, a lot of charisma and a lot of confidence in his ability as well.
Well, I'll tell you what, too, Shivani, he's a bit of a strange dude. You know, anybody that listens to that type of music day in and day out, look, he isn't going to quite be normal, don't you agree?
Well, I would agree with that.
That's called headbanger music.
Look at the power and look at the upper body development. I don't think he's ever looked in such good shape now. He's looking great. Better we've ever seen him. Heavy Metal Van Hammer in our first match. Pound to the chest to Kendall. From one turnbuckle to the other. Wow, what was force into that other turnbuckle.
He whipped him in there, and Kendo came shooting out of that buckle flat on his face down on the mat. You know, I often wondered, you ever notice how heavy metal rocks his head back and forth? What do you think? He's in a conference with David Lee Roth, or...
Catches Kendall in midair. And the backbreaker sends him down. You mean like spiritually?
I don't know. You know, these heavy metal headbangers, they're always listening. The music's ringing in their ears 24 hours a day.
I know this. When the bell rings, the man is ready to go. There's no question about it.
I bet his hero's Axl Rose.
Picks up Kendall. Belly to back suplex on Kenny Kendall.
And he bounced him off that canvas. Kendall came up about a foot and a half after hitting the canvas.
Hooks Kenny Kendall. Has him up high. Hammer rocks. The slingshot suplex. Good execution. Hooks the far leg. And he's got a three count.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Heavy Metal Van Hammer.
Heavy Metal Van Hammer begins worldwide with another great win. And let's take a look at it one more time, Jeff.
There you see Van Hammer missing the clothesline, but look at the strength as he catches Kendall coming off the ropes right there. Sheer power to hold a man of that size, because Kendall, no small man himself, boom, drives it down into a side breaker, back breaker, and here it is, slingshot suplex. Executed nicely off the rope. The added momentum drives him into the canvas, knocks the wind out of him, hooks the leg, nowhere to go. 1, 2, 3, big win for the Metal Man.
Coming up next, the Barbarian in singles competition. I'll be talking to Steve Austin as well. But right now, WCW Magazine.
Thanks, and welcome to the first edition of the WCW Magazine. Halloween Havoc, the pay-per-view exclusive coming your way October 25th, is going to see the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion, Ron Simmons, meeting the Barbarian. Ron Simmons, the athlete that said preparation was the key to his success, now must be prepared to meet this ominous athlete called the Barbarian, associated with the unpredictable Cactus Jack. We had a chance to catch up recently with Cactus Jack and the Barbarian.
This is the big one, Halloween Havoc. It's what we've been working for, what we've been praying for, and it's right around the corner. Ron Simmons, you're a heck of an athlete, a great world champion, but standing next to him, you look meek and mild. And standing next to him, you're gonna be something else, a beaten man. So shine that world title belt up. It's gonna look good right here.
Will Ron Simmons, the world's heavyweight champion, be prepared when he faces the Barbarian? Let's not forget, Jake the Snake Roberts was lurking in the background when Cactus Jack first became associated with the Barbarian and Butch Reed back at the Clash of the Champions. Halloween Havoc is going to be very interesting indeed. Contact your local cable operator. Tell them you want to be a part of Halloween Havoc, coming to you exclusively on pay-per-view October 25th. I'm Eric Bischoff. The action continues right here in World Championship Wrestling. So whatever you do, don't go away.
All right, fans, back with you here on Worldwide. Many young superstars in WCW. No question about it, this man, former World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin, the master of the stun gun, one of the most awesome moves in this sport.
You know, Tony, it's no secret that in the past, World Championship Wrestling has produced the greatest champions of all time. Now, whether that's tag team, world television title, or world heavyweight champions, WCW is the cream of the crop. So it should come, Tony Schiavone, as no secret that WCW will produce the champion who will take wrestling into the 90s. The wrestler who will dominate the sport like no other wrestler can. In the next few weeks, Schiavone, a metamorphosis will occur, and the creation that emerges is a new, improved Steve Austin that will be the World Heavyweight Champion.
Okay, comments from Stunning Steve Austin as we go back to the ring.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by Cactus Jack, parts unknown, weighing 296 pounds, the Barbarian!
What a team, what an alliance when you put Cactus Jack escorting this awesome athletic specimen, the Barbarian, to the ring as we go back to Gary Gambetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Lenoir, North Carolina, 239 pounds, Denny Deese.
Okay, before the match gets started, some interesting comments from Stunning Steve Austin, who talks about a metamorphosis and his focus at being one day world heavyweight champion. And then early in the hour, of course, we heard from Cowboy Bill Watts that top rope rule has been rescinded with the exception of not being able to drive a knee into the throat or the head of an opponent laying prone on the mat.
Well, what I like about it, Shivani, is this. Cowboy Bill Watts and WCW responded to the fans. The fans let their thoughts be known, and WCW responded to it.
The awesome Barbarian, ahead of steam. Truly one of the most powerful men ever. A man who has signed to meet Ron Simmons for the World Heavyweight title October 25th. And what a match that should be, of course, with Cactus Jack in his corner. That even spells more trouble for Ron Simmons or whomever would be the World Heavyweight Champion come October 25th.
Absolutely, October 25th. This man will get his shot at the title. And you know what you got to understand about the Barbarian, Shivani? He's got to be sick. I mean, think about it. Would you hang out with Cactus Jack?
Well, no, I would have to agree with that.
You know, would you put your career in Cactus Jack's hands?
Well, Cactus Jack knows how to hurt people. There's no question about that.
That's exactly what I said. So that makes the Barbarian just as sick as Mr. Bang Bang outside the ring.
And just as dangerous as well. The Barbarian. Now, he's up on the top rope, which, as we said, is now legal, but the man is prone. That was a headbutt. One, two, and three. Wins it with a headbutt off the top.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the Barbarian.
Now let's go to my colleague, one Mr. Tony Schiavone.
Okay, Jesse, thank you very much. As we said with Steve Austin, WCW prides itself in having the greatest young athletes in the world. Please welcome with me two of them right now, bringing it this time the natural Dustin Rhodes along with Eric Watts. Eric, great to see you. And Dustin, let me talk to you first before we talk to Eric. We saw last week on Worldwide Wrestling, tremendous win for you and Barry Windham. You've been an awesome tag team in WCW, no question about that.
Me and Barry have been around a long time. We've done a lot of things together, and I would definitely right now like to throw our names in the hat for the World Tag Team title, Tony.
Okay, World Tag Team title, no question, and tag team competition. Let's talk about singles competition. We heard Steve Austin, he wants to be World Heavyweight Champion. That's the goal of everybody, to make it to the top. What are your maybe short-term goals here in WCW?
Well, I want to take each day step by step. First of all, Tony, you know, everybody wants to conquer the world. But my number one goal lies around the waist of Ravishing Rick Rude. That's the United States title. And right now, I want to go on record and challenge Ravishing Rick Rude for the United States Championship.
Okay, a challenge from the natural Dustin Rhodes. I want to talk to Eric for just a second.
What do you mean, Eric the rookie, Watts?
Okay, Eric, you know, we have seen you at ringside watching the matches, and there's been a lot of talk about your training to become a pro wrestler. Can you compare the training you had as a collegiate football player in Louisville to your training as you prepare to go into the ring?
Well, you know, I played under Coach Howard Snellenberger at the University of Louisville, which is known to be a sergeant around the college ranks. However, wrestling being the most demanding sport in the world, I've had to ask for a little bit of help. I asked Dustin Rhodes, I asked Barry Windham, I get pointers from Magnum TA and Ricky Dragon Steamboat. So I feel I've gone as fast and as far as I can.
Okay, and the fans are wondering, hey, when are you going to start? When are we going to see you in the ring?
Well, you never know. I mean, it could be today, it could be tomorrow. I'll just wait for WCW to give me that call. I'll be ready.
Okay, I'm sure he's
funny. I've been in the ring with him myself, and believe me, I do believe he's ready.
Okay, the natural Dustin Rhodes and Eric Watts fans. We'll have more on Worldwide Wrestling right after this time.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 235 pounds, Shane Douglas. His opponent from Palm Beach, Florida, 229 pounds, Scotty Flamingo.
All right, Shane Douglas, Scotty Flamingo, before the match gets underway, comments recorded earlier on from Shane Douglas.
When you talk about the greatest in world championship wrestling, you have to understand that when you come here, people think they're going to be able to make you back down. Take a step away, you see. Shane Douglas is not like that. With the belly to belly, I'm not taking a step away from anyone.
All right, comments from Shane Douglas talking about that belly-to-belly suplex that he has learned, of course, under the guidance of former U.S. Heavyweight Champion Magnum T.A. And look at the intensity of Shane Douglas.
Well, I'll tell you what you got right here. You got two of the young lions of WCW, two young men that are in outstanding physical condition and want to make their way to the top. And only one of them's going to survive, Shivani.
No question about it, we have some tremendous young athletes. We just heard from Eric Watts and Dustin Rhodes, and now we see Flamingo and Shane Douglas. He got a cover to Flamingo and got a one count out of it, and he goes right back to the attack once again, but a single leg pickup that time.
You know, I'm a little disappointed, though, this week, Shivani. You haven't thanked me.
For what, Justin?
For saying your name on Entertainment Tonight.
Well,
a few weeks ago.
To the midsection.
I'll make you famous yet.
Snapmare takeover. I'm not going to hold my breath on that one.
Well, I won't say your name no more if you ain't nice to me. And look at that beautiful swinging neck breaker right there by Scotty Flamingo.
And got a two count out of it. Scotty Flamingo, certainly one of the men who will be vying, I'm sure, in that light heavyweight tournament, which, according to Bill Watts, is tentatively scheduled for early of 1993 now. We look forward to that. He is going right after Shane Douglas. Very aggressive here. Scotty Flamingo hooking Douglas. Picks him up. Snap suplex over the top. One, two, and almost got the three count that time.
You know what I like about Flamingo? The guy's well-schooled in the moves. Plus, he'll bend and he'll break the rules a little bit. You see him choking right there? He'll throw in a kick. He'll throw in a cheap shot now.
One, two, on a sunset flip that time, and Douglas almost got the win. But it's Flamingo back to the attack, and he goes to the back of the head again. And again he goes. Flamingo, high-impact blows now. Snapmare takeover, and he's going right after Shane Douglas.
Well, Flamingo got a warning, a bit of a stern warning there from the referee about the closed fist. You know, you got to try to sneak those closed fists in because, as we all know in wrestling, you are not allowed to hit with a closed fist. You can hit with the forearm, you can hit with the elbow, but not the fist.
Back of the neck again. Still high impact maneuvers this time by Flamingo. He tried a swinging neck breaker, but too close to the ropes. Douglas held on nicely. And that hurt him. Douglas to the midsection with a foot. Flamingo back on the attack. But Douglas pinned in the corner, trying to fight his way out. Irish whip to the other side. Shane Douglas! One, two, got a two count.
And a beautiful cross body off that rope when he came in. A couple of right hands by Douglas. Flamingo in the row, and he caught him with the point of the elbow. Right on the chin.
Great execution by Douglas again. Hooking Flamingo, picks him up, raw power that time from a standing position. Got him up high, vertical suplex. And now Shane Douglas. After the vertical suplex, shooting Flamingo in. There's the belly-to-belly suplex. That's the move. One, two, and it's over.
And here's your winner, Shane Douglas.
Still to come, our Halloween Havoc Control Center. But right now, our Jolly Rancher Colossal Crunch of the Week, Jeff.
The Crunch of the Week. I'll tell you what, here's Shane Douglas firing Flamingo into the ropes. Catches him with the belly-to-belly Magnum T.A. Be a proud man right there. Drives him into the mat, hooks the rope, wind knocked out. One, two, and three. Big win for Shane Douglas.
Jim Ross in the Control Center next. Right now, though, WCW Magazine.
Thanks, and welcome to another edition of the WCW Magazine. Coming your way Sunday, October 25th, it's Halloween Havoc only on pay-per-view. Contact your local cable operator and tell them you want to be a part of Halloween Havoc. One of the great matches you're going to see, Ravishing Rick Rude meeting Chono. This is a rematch from their previous meeting at the Sumo Palace in Tokyo when Ravishing Rick Rude lost to Chono in the finals. Now, recently, Jim Ross had a chance to talk to Ravishing Rick Rude as they viewed the footage in this match.
And there you see Ravishing Rick Rude in control here. This match almost 30 minutes in length.
I stopped him on that move, Jim. You know, this off-the-top thing threw me off in the beginning of the tournament, conflicting with the WCW rules.
As the match progressed, he did gain the upper hand here. And quite honestly, you took every shot that he could dish out.
I took all his best shots, and I kept coming back.
Look at the impact from this superplex as Ravishing Rick Rude hits this very hard ring.
I'm still feeling that one on the low back. But here now, here's where I take control.
Rude dominating right here.
Watch me stick him with this pile driver. Right there, it was all over. I knew I had him beat.
Why didn't you cover the guy?
Because two times previously I covered him, and the referee would not give me a three count. I was trying to knock him cold here. I thought that was the only way I had to win.
The Ravishing Rick Rude goes up to the top rope. A legal maneuver for a high-risk move. This was the exact move that you defeated your previous opponents with. You didn't use the Rude Awakening. You used the knee off the top rope.
That's right. The only mistake I made is I didn't go for the Rude Awakening. But here I stuck him with that, and I had him pinned once again for a three count. The referee wouldn't count three. Look at him.
He's frustrated. He can't put Ravishing Rick Rude away.
In his hometown, and you see every one of those fans is Japanese. Everyone pulling against me. Look at there. Out on the floor, the referee's not there to make a count. Do you know why? He's distracting me over on the side. He's saying something in Japanese. I don't know what it is. There. You saw it, Jim. Look at this now. One, two, three. A quick three count.
Well, as I mentioned earlier, Ravishing Rick Rude, upset over the loss that he sustained at the hands of Chono in the finals of that NWA tournament at the Sumo Palace in Tokyo, Japan. Now, later on in the hour, in the Halloween Havoc Control Center with Jim Ross, we're going to be hearing from the United States heavyweight champion, Ravishing Rick Rude, and we'll get his comments for Chono and Ravishing Rick Rude's plans of becoming the U.S. heavyweight champion and the NWA heavyweight champion when he faces Chono in the rematch at Halloween Havoc, only on pay-per-view, Sunday, October 25th. Contact your local cable operator and tell them you want to be a part of Halloween Havoc. I'm Eric Bischoff. The action continues here in World Championship Wrestling right after this very brief timeout. This is the Halloween Havoc Control Center. I'm Jim Ross. Welcome back, everyone. Last week here, we talked about three of the great main events that had been signed for Halloween Havoc exclusively on pay-per-view Sunday, October 25th. Ron Simmons will defend the WCW World Heavyweight Championship against The Barbarian. You'll see Ravishing Rick Rude in a rematch with Masahiro Chono for the NWA title. And the much-anticipated Spin the Wheel, Make the Deal matchup involving Sting and Jake the Snake Roberts. Now, let's go to this piece of videotape. The World's Tag Team Championship will also be decided. Here's the story.
The World Tag Title matchup at Halloween Havoc will pit the Steiners against the Champs, Steve Williams and Terry Gordy. Two teams who know each other quite well. It all began back in June when Doc and Gordy shocked the Steiners by winning the second round match in the NWA tournament. Then on July 5th in Atlanta, Doc and Gordy won the WCW World Tag Team belts from Rick and Scott. They went on to win the NWA titles on July 12th as the dejected Steiners had to look on. October 25th gives Rick and Scott their shot at regaining tag team's ultimate prize.
What a tag team matchup that will be exclusively on pay-per-view. And now let's hear from the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion, Ron Simmons, about his matchup with The Barbarian.
Being heavyweight champion means defending this title. And that's exactly what I will be doing. Halloween Havoc, Barbarian, I know you've got that big foot. I've seen you knock people out. I've seen you literally put them out of their mind. But you and I match up size for size, pound for pound, muscle for muscle. The only thing I can say is it will be the best man that will come out the winner. Halloween Havoc, brother, I'm going to prove to you my foot is bigger than you.
Ron Simmons is well aware that this is going to be a tremendous challenge for him at Halloween Havoc exclusively on pay-per-view. And now let's hear from the United States heavyweight champion, Ravishing Rick Rude, who will face Masahiro Chono at Halloween Havoc for the NWA title.
Chono-san, anata horu, STF, owari.
How about it, Deuce? How about a Japanese boy coming over to the United States and still being the hometown favorite? Well, that's okay, Chono. You see, I happen to know there ain't a soul in the United States who isn't jealous of Ravishing Rick Rude. They want to see you win, but they're going to go home heartbroken.
It's obvious to me that Ravishing Rick Rude and his Japanese expert Medusa have a very elaborate plan for Masahiro Chono come Halloween Havoc exclusively on pay-per-view. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear from the two men that will compete and spin the wheel, make the deal.
This is a rare instance, Sting. Spin the wheel, make the deal. It's your first time. And it will definitely be your last Halloween Havoc. Spin it, Sting, if you dare.
Jake the Snake, every time I think about what you did to me, I cannot wait to get to Philadelphia. I can't wait to get to Halloween Havoc. And most important, I can't wait to spin that wheel and make the deal.
Four big matches announced here today in the Halloween Havoc Control Center. Everyone eagerly anticipating the spin the wheel, make the deal matchup. Jake the Snake Roberts and the Stinger. Don't forget Ron Simmons. We're taking on the Barbarian. What sort of influence will Cactus Jack and Hacksaw Butch Reed have in the Barbarian's preparation? We're going to see Ravishing Rick Rude challenge Masahiro Chono for the NWA title. It sounds as if Rude and Medusa have a big plan and a big surprise, more specifically, in store for the NWA champion. And what about the World Tag Team Championship matchup as well? We'll have the complete lineup for you next week, but remember, to be a part of Halloween Havoc exclusively on pay-per-view, you've got to pick up your telephone. You've got to call your local cable company. Don't miss Halloween Havoc coming your way on Sunday, October 25th.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following feature confrontation, it is a non-title tag team match. It is set for one fall with TV time remaining. Introducing first, now residing in Nagoya, Japan, total combined weight, 520 pounds. They are the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Dr. Death, Steve Williams, and Terry Bam Bam Gordy.
Now, just like we said at the top of the program, much anticipated matchup, and you're going to see it exclusively here on Worldwide. Doc and Gordy, the tag team champs of the world, set to go.
Oh, yeah.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents in this non-title match. Introducing from Detroit, Michigan, total combined weight, 525 pounds. Rick Steiner, Scott Steiner, the Steiner Brothers.
What an ovation for Scott and Rick Steiner. And you know, just right now, with Doc and Gordy being the champs, the Steiners, and of course, Arn Anderson, Beautiful Bobby, along with Michael Hayes, embroiled in what's been going on with them. I would think right now WCW Tag Team Wrestling is at an all-time high.
It's never been better, and I'll tell you what, the Steiners are not in a good mood, Shivani. You know why?
Why's that?
Michigan tied Notre Dame a few weeks ago.
Terry Bam Bam Gordy will begin things against Scott Steiner. I know from talking to Scott, he can remember all too well. It all started back in Charleston, South Carolina, back in June, when they clipped the knee out from Scotty, and Doc and Gordy went on to advance in the NWA tournament. And then, of course, it went on from there. Full-arm drag, a twist from Scotty, and a reversal from Terry. Gordy sends Scott Steiner down. What do you look for early on in this match?
Well, I look for this. I look for both of them trying to establish some wrestling, see which team, because they're all four of them are solid, down-to-earth wrestlers. They're going to test each other, see who can get the advantage. You saw Gordy yank the hair. If there's any rule breaker that goes on, it'll come from Doc and Gordy.
Scotty Steiner twice now. Shoulder block takedown. Dr. Death cut that off, and all of a sudden, all four men in. You talk about animosity. Good elevation, both men. Sending Doc Gordy down and out.
I'll tell you what, the Steiners let the champs have it on that one. And look at Rick Steiner running around the ring. He's fired up. The champs are outside right now, but they're veterans and they're going to regroup themselves.
That's exactly what they're doing, regrouping. Randy Anderson asserting himself the referee assigned with this matchup. A lot of taunting was going on, I know, as Scott and Rick were making their way in the ring from Doc and Gordy. Of course, not only did Doc and Gordy go on in the tournament, not too long after that, they had their classic draw at Beast Blast, and then won the World Tag Team belts in the Omni.
And a lot has gone down between these two teams.
Hey, I'll tell you what, the Steiner brothers aren't the brightest guys in the world when it comes to being rogue scholars or nothing. But they do know one thing. They know championships mean money. And right now, their wallets are getting a little thinner because they don't have the belts anymore.
Scotty fights out. Both men in him in the corner. Dr. Death gets a tag. Comes right in to the Andre takeover. And Scott working on the arm of Dr. Death, Steve Williams. Doc has tremendous upper body strength. And I'm sure Scotty now, by working on the upper body, wants to take that away from him.
Oh, yeah. Get him down on the mat. Scotty Steiner likes his array of high impact aerial moves, and they need to take that away from him. And oh, Dr. Death is caught now with the dog face gremlin in there.
I would think also, as Rick Steiner gets the tag in here, Jess, that there has to be a tremendous amount of emotion from the Steiners to win, to be able to win this match. And you got to look at also Doc and Gordy, they've been in Japan. So maybe they are not 100%. Maybe they are still on a Japanese timetable, so to speak.
Well, being the world champions, you have commitments all over the world. You could be in Tokyo today and New York City tomorrow, San Francisco the next day. You're going to be all over the world. But believe me, Doc and Gordy are ready. They're the champions. They're not going to give them up.
3-point stance. Doc explodes off the line that time, taking down Rick Steiner. Wow.
I'm Dr. Death, Steve Williams, and look at the dog face gremlin jumping around in that ring, wishing he had a milk bone right now.
Fans, we have to take a break. If something happens during the break, the video tape machines are running. We'll show you what happened. If not, this match continues right after this. Tony Schiavone, Jesse the Body Ventura back with you on Worldwide. The match continues, a special challenge match. Steiners against Dr. Dusty Williams, Terry Bam Bam Gordy. The Steiners have taken it right to the champs right here.
And they're outside the ring, going at it punch for punch. Scott Steiner and Dr. Dusty, Steve Williams.
But he's in the wrong corner, Scotty Steiner. He was fighting Doc, where Terry can just jump down and attack, and that's exactly what he did.
Well, that's smart tag team wrestling. Even outside the ring, if you can keep him in your corner, outside the ring, you can do damage.
Now, Doc, sending Scott Steiner on the inside. It was the game plan of Doc and Gordy to go after Scott Steiner back in June to wear him down, because he always wrestles on a lot of emotion. He is the younger of the Steiner brothers, and that's exactly what they're doing now, attacking the youngest member. And these two veterans, double team takedown, one, two, almost got him. Almost got Scott Steiner.
Beautiful double shoulder block by the champions, Bam Bam Gordy and Dr. Death.
Working on Scotty again to the neutral corner, head first to the turnbuckle. What a great matchup we're having this week on Worldwide. We have a big six-man next week we'll tell you about in just a few moments. But right now, the action is hot and heavy, and Terry Gordy just stomping away at Scott Steiner.
And I've said it before, it's about time Scott Steiner needs to make a tag. He's been in the ring far too long and absorbed too much punishment. Beautiful vertical suplex textbook by Bam Bam Gordy. One, two, oh, and Steiner barely kicks out.
Almost got him. Scotty. Now to the knee of Steve Williams. And look at that, cut off Scott Steiner before he could get over and make the tag to his brother.
Well, the champ started off a little bit slow as this bout went on, but you can see momentum building in the champions. They're getting it picked up right now. Oh, sunset flip.
Sunset flip. Right hand to the head. Got him, one, two. And Steve Williams got out of that one. But look at that. He rolled Scotty towards the corner. Steve Williams, even though he was nailed by Rick Steiner, had the whereabouts to go right back to the attack.
And look at this series, three crashing elbows down on the kidney area.
Cover Scott. He hooked the near leg, got a two count that time. Scotty got out of that, but he is really hurting from those elbows to the back from Dr. Death. Double team. This is why they are the tag team champions. You're seeing classic tag team work right here.
I'll tell you, the last 4 or 5 minutes of this match, it's been all Doc and Gordy, the champions. The Steiner brothers have had the ring cut off. The pressure's on them. They better come up with something.
Terry Gordy Head of steam. Knocked down Scott. Covers it. One, two. Scott is out. Did not hook a leg that time, but he goes back to the attack again. And they are really trying to unload here on Scotty Steiner. They want to make sure there is no tag made.
They're punishing Scott Steiner. I have never seen Scott Steiner as vulnerable as against the champions right here. Look at him measure. Oh, he ducked out of the way of that one. But look at Williams. Pulled that right hand back, sets him up, and catches him with two more. And a big chop.
Williams casts an eye over to Rick Steiner. Turns Scotty over, hooks the leg, and just pulls back. This is also working on the back like he was doing earlier with the elbows, and now just pulling back on that leg.
We could get a submission right here, or we could get Rick Steiner having to come in and save his brother. Wouldn't that be sweet, Shivani?
The half crab is on. Scott trying to get out, and the fans right behind the Steiners here. This matchup on Worldwide. And what a match it's been. Look at Gordy.
You know, by the time this holds over with, Scott Steiner may have one leg longer than the other.
And he may be able to make a tag right here. He's so close. He made the tag. He made the tag. And Rick Steiner's
Oh, ref didn't see it. Referee did not see the tag. He's sending Rick Steiner out of the ring.
And they go back to the leg in the back again. They are working on the back of Scott Steiner. Quite effectively. That tag was made, and he didn't see the tag on the other side, not allowing Terry Gordy to come in.
Referee did what he had to do. He did not see the tag, therefore he cannot allow it. A lot of irate fans at ringside, but hey, so be it.
That's right. He is taking control, the referee, Randy Anderson, this match. And now, Gordy in. Attack Scotty again. Scott moved out of the way. He slipped out of the way right to the floor. His only chance for defense was to move.
And that was pure instinct, Shivani. Scott Steiner is not sure right now whether he's in Detroit or New Orleans.
Tag has been made. He would not allow the tag on that side, but now gets Rick Steiner. Steiner handling both men. Scotty still down on the far side, as you can plainly see. Here's the Irish whip in. Picks him up. Power slam type maneuver. One. He cuts off Dr. Death.
Very smart move there by Rick Steiner. He covered, but he saw Dr. Death coming in, leveled him with a big right hand, and now he's measuring Bam Bam Gordy.
He backed up, but got in the line of Dr. Death, who knocked down Rick Steiner.
Hey, he who hesitates is lost. He waited too long.
Scotty, stomp it away. Gordy the back over the top. Two.
Gordy got him.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the Steiner Brothers.
And I'll be talking to world champion Ron Simmons right after WCW Magazine. How about that?
Thanks, and welcome to the final edition of this week's WCW Magazine. Wrestling fans, Arn Anderson, beautiful Bobby Eaton, recently defeated the Steiner Brothers in what many analysts refer to as the tag team upset of the year. But the Steiner Brothers, the competitors that they are, were quick to issue a challenge for a rematch. But as you're about to see, not long after issuing the challenge, Arn Anderson and beautiful Bobby Eaton came face to face with Rick Steiner, and things nearly got out of control.
We want to finish this once and for all. Anderson, Eaton, me and my brother are ready. We got one thing standing our way. That's you two. We get done with you. We're going to the top for those WCW World Tag Team Battle. I can beat you. I can beat you. I can beat you. And I know I can beat you. Let's do it right now.
Well, he's made a challenge, gentlemen. As Hayes going to fight Rick Steiner. Rick Steiner without his brother. He came out. He wants to take either one another. Scotty Steiner. The Steiner Brothers are ready.
The Steiner Brothers looking forward to a rematch with Arn Anderson, beautiful Bobby Eaton, and of course the strategist, Michael P.S. Hayes. And don't forget to contact your local cable operator and order Halloween Havoc exclusively on pay-per-view Sunday, October 25th. I'm Eric Bischoff. This has been the WCW Magazine, and the action continues right after this.
fans, before time slips away, I want to remind you next week on Worldwide, a big six-man, Sting and the Steiner Brothers together against Arn Anderson, Beautiful Bobby, and Ravishing Rick Rude. That'll be next week, and a look at Kensuke Sasaki will be coming our way from Japan very soon. But right now, welcome with me, the one and only heavyweight champion of the world, Ron Simmons! Okay, champ, the fans, you see the Seminole chops out everywhere. I know your dance card is full, if I can use that old cliche. Everybody's after the world heavyweight champion. But you know, we saw the Barbarian early on. And now the top rope rule has been rescinded. That gives him another weapon. He is an awesome specimen.
Yes, he is, Tony. But first, I cannot go without saying this and addressing these people here. There's no place like home. You understand me? And another thing, when I left here, going to Florida State University, I promised these people here and around the world that I will make them proud of me. And I think I did. When I got into professional wrestling, I promised them that I would do the same thing, that I would give it everything I had, and that I will make them proud of me once again. And I'm gonna let this speak for itself. And just like you said, the top rope has been reinstated. That can be an advantage and a disadvantage for a lot of people in this sport. But for the Barbarian, it's to his advantage because the man has put away a lot of people, a lot of opponents in the past with that top rope. But let me tell you something, Tony. That can also be in Ron Simmons' favor because I have been known to use the top rope, the second rope, the bottom rope, whatever it takes to get the job done. That's what Ron Simmons will do to defend this title and this belt and be the world's heavyweight champion going into Halloween Havoc. I have got to defend this belt up until that time, and it makes no difference. Whoever it is, whenever it is, I plan on being the world's heavyweight champion at Halloween Havoc and after.
The man, Ron Simmons. Man, we'll see you next week on Worldwide.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.